covered the brown fields, and the sparrows huddled in corners to keep warm. "When will spring come?" asked the little boy. "When you see the crocuses blooming all over the grass," his mother told him, scattering crumbs for the birds. But the grass was brown, and the ground was frozen under the snow. "When will spring come?" he asked his grandfather.
"When the peach tree blooms again," said the old man, and he knocked his pipe against the tree trunk.
But all the boy could see were the sharp, bare branches, until high on top of the tree, he spied a robin. "Hi, Mr. Robin," cried the boy. "When will spring come?" "It's here! It's here!" sang the robin, then flew away. But that night it snowed again, and the boy woke to a white world once more. After breakfast, he saw the robin. "Now, Mr. Robin, where is the spring?" he demanded. "Use your eyes! Use your eyes!" sang the bird, and he flicked his tail as he flew off to the woods. The little boy followed, and there by the brook he found the first pussy willows pushing out of their shiny brown shells. But the brook was frozen, and the snow lay on the ground. Still, spring didn't come. The days stayed cold and rainy, and everyone was out of sorts. The little boy grew more and more restless, and he teased the cat. His mother scolded him for tracking mud on her clean kitchen floor, and his grandfather complained about his stiff back. "Sometimes I think we never have any spring," said the little boy crossly as he put away his coat and rubbers. Only the robin seemed happy.